The wait is over, and it's a prince. This morning, the Duchess of Cambridge, Kate Middleton, gave birth to an 8-pound, 7-ounce baby boy. This is the third child for the Duchess and the Duke of Cambridge. Our royal correspondent, Max Foster, outside the hospital in London with all of the latest. Max, lay it out for us. Give us the details here.
Well, he's healthy. That's the main thing. They came into the hospital early this morning, the Duchess, in the early hours of labor, and then she delivered late morning. And we're expecting to see the family appear on those steps behind me, John. A family of five, hopefully, if George and Charlotte can come along and make it, if they've been allowed out of school. We've had the formal announcement at Buckingham Palace. That happens on an easel, an ancient easel, which has been used since Buckingham Palace was first set up, really, first built and used as a palace. So there's been some pomp and ceremony today, but really it's all about the photo, which we're expecting a little later on, John.
Can't wait to see that. Now, the nuts and bolts here, Max. Where does this baby boy, name yet to be determined, fit in the line of succession?
Well, that's interesting, you see, John, because not only has Prince Harry been bumped down the order to number 6, this baby will be at number 5, but in the past, in previous generations, he would have gone up to number 4 and bumped his older sister down the line of succession. But because they've changed the succession laws after 1,000 years, they finally got to the point where women have an equal right in succession. So this baby will be 5th in line of succession and will stay there, has a guaranteed place there. Harry goes down the running order there.
Harry gets pushed down, though I don't think it will diminish the interest on that royal wedding, which is still coming up right now, even though his path, you know, to the throne just became more difficult. All right, let's talk potential names here, because unlike many families where the baby is born and you learn the name right away, it doesn't exactly work like that, or necessarily work like that.
Well, no, and it's complete guesswork as well, but why don't we join the guesswork, which is sort of gripping social media right now? These are the top 3 names that are being bet on, at least. Arthur, Albert, and Frederick. Also, people talking about Philip, could be named after his great-grandfather, who's in his 90s, of course, was recently in hospital, is due at that wedding as well. This young baby will be the youngest guest at the royal wedding, so that's really what we're building up to next. But as you say, it's not a senior position in the line of succession, but we'll play into the royal story, as it were, and I can feel your excitement, John.
I'm hoping it's Severus Albus Windsor. That's the name that I want right now. Let's tie it all together. Let's tie it all together. Max Foster, outside the hospital for us. Thank you so much, Max. I appreciate it.